You're watching ES News. I'm Ellie Seckback reporting. Check out this video.
Really came out swinging the first round. Like, oh shit, gonna get that one.
What did you think?
I was going for Kirkland, but you know, it is what it is. Kirkland came out swinging like a motherfucker beast. He came out the first round. I was like, oh shit. And then he got caught. He got caught. That's what happened.
Did you watch the fight, Robert? Canelo Kirkland? What did you think?
Huh?
What did you think?
That was a good performance for Canelo. He got down. He did what he had to do. Kirkland gave him, you know, 3 rounds. It was a good fight. It was exciting.
The first round, Kirkland came out with Canelo. Yeah.
If Manny did that for the whole round.
Then Canelo catches him and drops him. And then, you know, the second round was still a little bit of, you know, good. There was some action. And then the third one was obviously knocked him out. But Kirkland gave him a fight. But, you know, he did what he had to do, you know, to at least give him a fight. He got knocked out. But doesn't make him look bad because he still went out.
He went out with his fucking hard ball.
Good, yeah.
I had that knockdown, dude. Got an 11.
That was a big.
Ow, that was an out.
Canelo looked great.
Canelo looked good. Yes, he did.
Hey, I gotta tell you, hundreds and hundreds, there were 31,000 fans there, and every fan that saw me asked, "Where's Robert? Where's Brandon? Where's Mikey? When is Mikey fighting? Yeah. When is Brandon fighting? Where's Robert?"
I'm on retirement, like fucking Mikey right now.
Brandon and Mikey are both retired.
Oh, speaking of retire, you have a question here from Alex. Robert, why did you retire so young? You couldn't get fights either?
Because I couldn't get fights either.
I talked to Roy Jones Jr. out there, and he said that if Brandon fights Provodnikov, he's paying $200 for the pay-per-view. That's what he said.
Hey, fuck it. Give me Provodnikov. I'll fight his ass right now. I don't got no fights. He don't got no fights. He got fucked up.
But he's got a big fucking cut like this.
No, he looked good. I saw him a week after the fight.
He's got a big
cut. So, what, 60 days, 90 days?
He can't fight for at least 5 or 6 months. I guarantee you that.
So, you need to fight somewhere else right now.
I just need to fight, dude. I just want to fight already. Fuck. That's bullshit, man.
Okay, how about this?
Lewis. Bullshit.
Lewis is asking, Brandon, you against Victor Ortiz. Can you make it happen?
Man, fuck that fucking guy. He ain't shit. He's a bitch.
Besides that, I don't even think he's training or fighting
anymore. He's a movie star now? He ain't fighting no more.
Okay, Boxing Commission is asking, when is Brandon gonna fight Ruslan?
I don't know. Whenever they can make it happen, we're ready for it.
Okay, Gary's asking.
Ready for it right now, my god damn it.
Gary's asking, when are you coming to the UK to fight Kell Brook?
When Kell Brook decides to grow some balls and stop calling me out and then takes an easy fight, that's when I'll go out there and fight him.
Maybe August?
I heard that, you know, it's bullshit, because now I heard that. Bob Burns said, well, they might put Manny Pacquiao with Kell Brook now.
Really?
But that leaves me out of fucking no date again. So it's a bunch of bullshit, man. It's a lot of
but
shit.
But Manny Pacquiao can't fight for 9 months, right?
I don't know, but they're talking about him fighting, that's what Bob Burns, what about fucking, that's what I heard. A little birdie around said that shit. So if that's true, that's fucked up.
And what?
That. Bob Arum's talking about Manny Pacquiao fighting Kell Brook in August. In August. And you know what I mean? That's a fucking bullshit.
But can Manny be ready by August?
I don't know, but
hey,
we're not even fighting, man. We want to fight already.
I ran into a friend of yours. Let me remember his name. I wrote it down because I knew I wouldn't remember. But he said, I'm from Garden City, goddammit.
Who's that?
Some guy that I a fighter that I ran into. He retired 7-0, 7-1.
Ooh.
I'll tell you his name. I have to find my note.
Ooh.
Oh, Chad Aquino.
Chad Aquino?
Yeah.
I know that he was an amateur fighter.
Yeah, then he turned pro. But he said that he knows you from Kansas City.
And amateurs.
If I see him, if I see his face, I remember. But at names, I'm not really good.
He looks like this dude.
No, he doesn't. Yeah.
So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Seckback, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Seckback. And you can follow me on Instagram, @EllieSeckback. Take a step back, cause it's a step back.